to have a final drink for the road. Into the bottom of this league, you will go. I wouldn't be so damn arrogant if I were you. Let's see where I stand when all this is through. I can sense some jealousy right over there, but doesn't look from my face that I really care. Step up your game, my friend, and let's see.
What's the problem?
My arm. Oh my god, my bloody arm. I think it's broken. Yep, it's broken. Well, that's just great, isn't it? Ow, what the hell have you done for assault?
Your arm isn't broken. You still tug one off to your own reflection.
You are the worst director ever. 4 days I've put up with your shit. I mean, what a stupid name for a character, Roast Pork, and a stupid title, Gangs and Roast Pork.
The name is fine. It's a very clever script. Now back off, Bambi.
My mate Spielberg never gave me any of this shit.
Like you know Spielberg.
I have you know my old man's busy mates with Spielberg, but whatever. Everyone take five.
Oh, I'm so sorry, Ron. I had no idea that there were two fucking directors.
Can you not tell? I'm on my break.
Oh, yeah. No, of course. Sorry. Please, by all means, take your break.
Where's my coffee?
Okay, everyone. Yes. Yeah. Take five. Bobby, sire, His Majesty, would you?
Are you okay, Warren?
I am. No, your head's so comfortable.
Shut up. Come on, man up. You need it back on set.
Oh, frisky Barbie.
Get off me! Don't call me Barbie.
Kinky.
Come on.
I'm sorry. Let me make it up to you. How about dinner?
Not a chance in hell.
Are you sure? I can't persuade you. Mm-hmm. You're beautiful. You're beautiful. It's true.
Come on, ladies. Pull your knickers up. But you need it back on set. Anil, can you go get me the Freeman brothers?
It's Roger Ainsley! I'm a member of staff here, you world record wanker. And only fellow members get to call me that. I'm doing you a favour being on the camera as it is.
Sorry. Rog.
Use that term again, I'll fashion your foreskin into fishbait.
I'm circumcised.
Oi! Twats! Your raggedy walk on ass is over here. Okay? Pete?
Whoa.
What is this? This is bloody gang life. What possessed you to come dressed as this? You're meant to be the Freeman brothers, right? The hardest men on the block. You going to a fancy dress party later? Barbie, will you please get 50 pence here back into wardrobe and get them to make him at least more threatening than Barney the fucking dinosaur.
If only we had a decent producer.
Joanna, these crutches really don't suit you. You should get them in pink. It would look well cute.
So, are you going to be able to dance again before Christmas?
The doctor said it was quite a bad break, so we'll have to wait and see how the physio goes.
What a mess. Who glazes a dance floor with washing up liquid?
Exactly. If I didn't know any better, I'd think there was a conspiracy going on.
Really?
25 grand is a lot of money to win, and I'm not on the team anymore.
Well, we'll get you back on editing or something. I must say, we could have done with your organisational skills.
Peter taken on too much.
His competency in certain areas leaves a lot to be desired.
Well, that's true in many ways.
Yeah, I know.
I should never have told you.
You're right. I'm your lecturer. You really shouldn't have.
Oh, come on, guys. Let's go move on. What time's it wasting?
Peter?
Oh. And speaking of waste... Yes, Warren?
Where's my coffee?
I'm sorry. I haven't got time to open a Starbucks. I'm trying to make a film here.
Well, you're not doing a very good job of it.
Oh, bloody hell. I had no idea we're in the presence of film guru Warren Long. Please, oh great one, tell me your secrets, because honestly, I've just been guessing up to this point.
Finally, some recognition!
Oh my god, you complete and utter...
Stop fighting, you two!
Warren, coffee for you.
It's cold.
Oh, sorry, your lordship.
Unlike you, Barbie, it's hot.
Excuse me, whilst I throw up. Hey, babe, how's it hanging?
Wow, Harry, are you always this creepy, or are you making a special effort for me?
And how's Daddy's little girl?
You eat an extra bowl of charm this morning.
Miss me. See, while you guys were working on your little project, I've been working on a real set. EastEnders, baby.
Yeah, observing. Are you still jealous that I got this writing gig?
Oh, please. We both know you didn't deserve it. Come on now.
What do you mean?
Well, a little birdie told me that it wasn't your fantastic writing skill that got you the job now, was it?
Well, I'm not surprised to hear that you're getting information from birds. It shows in your writing because someone has been dropping crap all over the page.
You'll want to talk about crap writing.
You never seem to actually accept that there are people out there who are better than you.
There was some favouritism involved there. Some nepotism.
God, did you see Strictly the other night? Talk about amazeballs. I loved Kelly and Ed's salsa number. Ooh!
No, Barbara. I haven't been able to watch it since my leg got broken. Makes me well jealous.
Oh, foot and mouth disease.
Huh?
I forgot you broke it dancing.
Forget? You glazed the floor. 5 minutes before I was due to rehearse and the glaze was contaminated with soap. Didn't you know it'd be dangerous?
Joanna, all I was doing was what was asked of me. What would I ever do?
Who asked you?
Peter. He wanted it to look all smart for your performance.
Okay. Peter got you to glaze the floor?
Yeah.
You never told me before.
No?
That scheming little prick.
That stupid, self-centered pig. Oh,
here he goes again. He's been like this all week. He needs to chill out.
Bobby. Take care of the expenses for me, will you? There's about 100 quid in there. It's for the actors, and don't fucking lose it.
What are you doing here?
Checking in on what was my production, or as everyone else would call it, a dog's dinner.
What do you mean?
He contaminated the glaze and got our bumbling bimbo to do the floor minutes before I rehearsed.
Get away. You know, there's something fishy going on.
What's fishy about him contaminating the glaze?
What's the difference between a piano and a fish? You can't tune a fish. T-U-N-A. Like the fish. Because you can tune a piano. Tune sounds like tuna.
Focus.
Sorry. Guess what I heard?
What?
Turns out Emma's dad is funding the project.
Shut the front door. How do you know that?
Emma's dad's an agent, right? So one of the actors I met on EastEnders is his client. So we got talking about where I studied, and he mentioned that Emma's dad is funding one of his daughter's projects at the same uni. What other project could it be?
Well, this is a lot to take in, Harry.
Now you know why I'm so pissed off.
So let me get this straight. You don't get the scriptwriting job because Emma's father is funding the film.
Right, though I don't want anyone to know that I know.
Then I accidentally break my leg so that Peter can take over.
Yeah, if luck was shit, you'd have diarrhea.
Harry, you're full of shit.
Thoughts just crossed my mind.
Must have been a long and lonely journey.
No, really. Wonder how we can repay the favour.
What do you mean?
Oh, bloody useless production crew. It can't even keep a tidy workspace. You know, this is a fuck-up.
Bloody fuck-up productions.
Barbie, are you even listening to what I'm saying? Oi, hello? Barbie?
What's up?
Why have you seen the state this place? I've seen tidier landfill sites. Now clean it up.
Here, Rog.
What?
Oh, for God's sake.
So last week.
You cold?
Yeah, there's a problem with the shot.
What do you mean? What's the problem with the shot?
Warren.
He missed his mark.
Oh, I might have known. He's out of shot. Well, can't we reshoot it?
We could, but Warren's gone missing.
Well, let's find him, all right? We don't rap until I say rap.
Peanut, you couldn't direct traffic up a one-way street.
Warren wants his expenses.
I need to see my grandma. She's ill.
Well, that's lovely. But we need you on set. You missed your mark.
I didn't miss my mark. The mark was in the wrong place. I don't care. I need to see her.
Look, I'm the producer and the director. You go when I say you go.
Peter? A word? You do know that Warren is doing this gratis, right?
Yeah. That's a complete pain in the arse.
Yeah, that may be so, but he's the best we could get at such short notice. We could have worse things in your backside. Like piles.
Fine, yeah. You're right.
So?
Look, Warren. We need you. If you'd consider staying for a bit longer, that would be greatly...
I don't care. I need to see my grandma. She's got an ingrown toenail.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't realise it was fucking terminal.
You're being really horrible to me. I don't know why I agreed to do this.
Oh, Bob. Barbara. God, it's good to see you. Please take Warren to the set.
In that case, I'd love to stay.
Great.
Besides, do you need me? I'm a classically trained actor. I'm going to be bigger than DiCaprio and Depp. People are going to write books about me. So... it's about time that you start to appreciate me and realise this production would be nothing without my talent.
Just taking you to set, Warren. It's not like we're going on a date or anything.
I'm an actor, Barbara. I'm rehearsing for when the time comes.
Do you suffer from insanity?
No. I enjoy every minute of it.
Oh, God.
Okay. I expect better from you, Peter.
But the guys in power are going to toss us.
Yes, I know. But he's all we've got, remember that.
If he's an actor, then I'm next in line at the Vatican.
You need to seriously calm down.
I've been perfectly calm throughout this entire shoot.
You calm? I've seen calmer passengers in a plane crash.
No, I... what? Seriously, the script...
There is nothing wrong with the script. A bad shagger blames his tool.
It's a hot defence of Emma.
You can't blame her for your deficiencies.
I've seen better scripts on toilet paper.
Well, I take it you don't see what I see on her.
No. Speaking of which, when was your last boyfriend, Susan?
What do you mean?
You know, when did you last? I'm working with my hands tied.
Yeah, I heard you like a bit of bondage.
What?
Anyway.
What do you mean?
Even with your hands tied, you couldn't get it on?
Who told you?
Look, I know erectile dysfunction is common in older men, but you're only 24, Peter. You should seek some medical advice.
I did not
have... Be honest, Peter. Perhaps it's not girls you like.
Barbie?
Not Elba.
Dinner offer's still available.
Warren, do you know how I would save you from drowning?
No, how?
I'd take my foot off your head. I wouldn't be inclined to, because my usual answer is no. And even if you were the last guy on earth, my answer would still be no. I'd get a better lay from an orangutan. Now go away, I'm busy.
Listen, I'm not trying to impress you. I watch PG films without parental guidance.
What the hell, Warren? Leave me alone. I could never be interested in someone as shallow, self-centered and arrogant as you. Also, I heard you have a tiny todger.
Well, that's just not true. Don't listen to a Sex Pistol. In a competition, you'd win prizes.
Harry, this is preposterous. You have no idea what you're talking about. I would never take a bribe from a parent.
Well, I don't think she got it because she's a better writer.
I'm not going to keep telling you she got it on talent alone.
This is a nationwide competition.
Look. We're just going round in circles here. You've just come to me with this crazy accusation.
Then if it's not true, why did Emma get the gig?
Yeah.
You like Emma, don't you, Susan?
I think we've said enough, don't you?
I'm not gonna let this rest.
What do you plan to do?
I plan to stop them from winning the competition.
Susan, I really need to discuss something with you. Hey Emma, come in.
Shut the door.
Be honest with me.
Yes?
It's just that Harry said something earlier and can't stop thinking about.
Go on.
Well, he said something about favouritism.
Emma, that's just not true. You know, Harry is still mad because he didn't get the job.
Was it you who got me the gig? Harry is a better writer.
No, he's not. You underestimate your talent.
Why would he say something like that, though? Was it you? I know you like me and I like you.
Emma, you got the job because you're a talented scriptwriter and everybody believes in you.
Was it you, Susan? Oh, hey!
What the hell are you doing here?
Why shouldn't I be here?
Just give me the keys. I need to get into the office.
Just go in, it's open.
Open. You left the office open. Barbie, the expenses are in there. You took them with you, didn't you?
Expense? What?
Barbie, if stupidity was painful, you'd be in agony. Just come on! Thinking.
I don't know, you never gave me any expenses.
Yes, I did. You're absolutely useless. I left them right in front of you.
In front of me? What, on the desk? You told me to throw all of that away. I was just doing what you said.
Gone. It's all gone. Cleaner. Oh, gone. Bins. Where are the bins?
One of a kind, Jimmy Choos.
But if they did a degree in stupidity, you'd pass with flying colours, just forget about your stupid shoes.
Well, where are the bins?
Down there.
Oh my god! Wait!
What?
My shoes!
Just hurry up! In there.
I'm not going in there.
You want to be part of this film? You are the production secretary.
There's cold spaghetti marinara in there. I can see the muscles.
Oh, when we all go to LA, you'll be left behind.
Really? You were considering giving me one of the three prize tickets to LA?
23. Oh, get in there. Come on, keep looking.
This is so horrible! I could need 8 showers after this.
Oh, good.
Nice to see you too.
You still looking for your travel expenses?
Yes, I am. Where are they?
This reminds me of a video I saw once on the internet.
I don't want to know.
Thank you very much. You should cover yourself in food more often. It has a certain eroticism for gluttons.
Oh well.
You could buy yourself some talent with that.
If Warren steps out of line just once tomorrow, I'm gonna cut his dick off and stick up his nose. I'm gonna bait his bollocks in basil and chili.
You know, talking to yourself is the first sign of madness.
Fuck.
How's it going?
Whoa. Where you been? Oh, the Andromeda Galaxy?
I know. Producing and directing together is so stressful. It's a shame you have to do both roles. If only I hadn't been so inconsiderate and broken my leg.
Accidents happen.
Yeah. See, I heard on the Vine that you got someone to make the floor slippery moments before my rehearsal.
Conspiracy theories.
This was gonna be my big break.
And you got it.
I wasn't talking about my leg, you twat. You pervert. Does anyone know about you and your dog impersonations? I should have taken a photo and posted it on the internet, but we were in love then.
You've been telling Susan about my bitch.
You got Barbara to glaze the floor so I might fall.
Well, pity it's only your leg and not your neck.
Down, boy, heel.
You shouldn't be telling people.
Yeah, and you shouldn't be breaking people's legs.
You know what?
What?
Break the other one. I'm looking for a come up. This is fucking awesome. Ow. I'm gonna pop some tags. Only got $20 in my pocket. I'm hunting, looking for a come up. This is fucking
well, on set.
Awesome. Oh, it's cold.
Bobby, we're trying to shoot.
Oh, sorry.
And action.
If you think you can take me alive, you are sorry, mistake.
Cut. What the hell are you doing? What? The Russian accent.
Oh, that. I was just improving the script.
Oh, God give me fucking strength. You are the most stuck-up actor.
Hey, watch what you say. You're looking at the next Leonardo.
Da Vinci.
DiCaprio.
And I'm Orson fucking Welles. You have to listen to the director.
Peter, how many intelligent students does it take to change a light bulb?
What?
Both of them.
You know what, Warren? I'd rather stick my head down Quasimodo's toilet after it had a curry than work with you.
And you know what, Peter? I feel so bathed by your warm embrace that I quit. Good luck finding someone this talented. So, you doing anything later? I'm free. From now?
Yes, I am. I'm making a doll of you to stick pins into.
Been in any interesting dustbins lately?
Hey, Warren. Here's your coffee.
Hey everyone, what should call a guy with a rabbit up his ass?
Warren!
I went out to make some money cause I got no shame. Pour a little poison on my good name. Down to Carolina through the pouring rain. Pour a little poison on my good name. Just pour a little poison on my good name. Well, the rain came down and it soaked my shoes. I'm just a whiny little English boy singing the blues. I got a head full up of problems that I ain't gonna fix when I'm staring at the walls inside the Motel 6. And I'm storming in the Georgia like a midnight train. Pour